Hello, today I'm going to share with you the DNA of a perfect prospect nurturing process, why it matters to you, and how we implement it in your sales automation machine. In our Done For You and Done With You services, we build prospect nurturing sequences usually in around 30 days. It is a work that we do together. I show you how to implement it, I do the technical part, and of course I need your assistance to come up with the right content. It is all about to move your prospect from a cold customer, from a cold prospect to a hot prospect and make him ready to buy from you. Let's look at it like that. Prospect nurturing is a bit like dating for the first time. Nobody goes to bed or goes home with you on the first day, so the person likes to know you better, and that's also how sales works. We like to move from an anonymous state. Somebody sees you the first time, and it is all about building the relationship so that you get well known and the person, your prospect customer, knows what to expect from you, so that he gets the feeling, can I move on with this company or not? So let's have a look what prospect nurturing means and where it gets important when we build a sales automation machine for you. Usually the first thing that we do with our customer is that we build a welcoming sequence, a landing page sequence as it is known, that usually has a kind of a traffic source, can be organic traffic or it can be a Facebook or a Google ad that brings people to an opt-in page where they, in best case, give us their email address, their name, and they move on to the authority amplifier, as we call it, where you have the first chance to give the prospect the feeling who you are, what you can do for them. And this is actually our first goal, to give the customer a feeling that he's on the right place, that he should get closer, and in best case go to the second goal, to book a call with you and build the relationship, sort out questions that he has, so that he can be a new client. So now usually people are very busy. They maybe come in here, they maybe find time to and watch this video, and the chance is high that they forget about you. So this is now actually where the nurturing sequences are coming in. The nurturing sequences is what we see up here and down here. So a nurturing sequence can be an ad that is sent to people that have already done this step or done this step, and it is about moving them to the next step in your funnel. The same thing happens with email sequences. They are also targeting again and again to bring them to the next step. Or when you work on them to get them book a call with you, you can entertain them with videos, actually like this one that I'm showing you here at the moment, where it is about making them motivated to arrive on your call and that they really like to hear what you have. This is what we call prospect nurturing, and let's dig a bit deeper and see where this actually starts. Generally, prospect nurturing starts on two possible points. Let's shortly talk about Facebook ads. When you run a Facebook ad that has the plan to bring people to a landing page where they give an email address, then Facebook records the people that have looked at your ad, have clicked on it, and it creates in the background an audience that you can retarget. The meaning of retargeting is, let me say, 20,000 or 30,000 people has seen your ad going down in your timeline. Maybe 2,000-3,000 of them clicked on it, came to your landing page. In best case, they gave already an email address, or maybe not. So you are you can actually use Facebook now to send these 3,000 people another information, a short video, a personal message that motivates them. Maybe they forgot yesterday to move on, they was too busy, it was the wrong moment. So they are motivated to find back to you, do this first step, and you will know with a proper site tracking which stage they have reached inside this process here. The mechanism of tracking on which points that a given prospect reached helps you to send them on this point here the message they need to do this step. On this point here, you help them to do this step, and it goes on like that. So on our website, when you maybe visit it, you will see that we use different ways to achieve the first goal, to generally get an email address. On our website, as an example, we give prospects to know about us better a series of free videos when they give us their email address, and we send them then a sequence of emails that shows them how I work and what they can expect from me. To give you a bit better picture how this technically works, I usually like to show this picture here and the message of the tip of the iceberg. Usually what a normal web agency is doing for you, they build website, they maybe build a shop for you, they say, yeah, you need a Facebook page and a landing page, you need to have videos, but all this alone is not going far when you don't put the automation together that plays around all these mechanisms here. So when we talk about the sales automation machine, it actually more looks like that. There is a lot of things going on under the surface. There is page trackings that have to be activated on your page, in Facebook maybe, building a custom audience. They are the leads that are stored in an autoresponder. They are tags that identify or can help you identify where this lead came from, in which stage he is at the moment. They are the swim lanes that we are talking about. They are connected apps and many other things that are brought together with 5, 6, 7 systems that work independently together to achieve your goal to have a sales automation machine. Now, I like to give you shortly only a picture of what a simple quiz can do when we talk about nurturing of your customer or also profiling your customer. Let me assume you have a little quiz on your website that asks the prospect 3, 4, 5, 10, 20 questions, and this data is collected, and it is actually quite mind-blowing what this simple quiz can give you to learn better who your customer is and to draft much better messaging later in the process when you go back to him. Now, in our onboarding sequence, we use a quiz actually after this stage here, after the authority amplifier, we use in between here a quiz or a questionnaire to prepare ourselves and the prospect for the call that he has already booked. Now, we have a sequence with a number of questions, and this is actually what we get out of that. To store the results, we actually are given the email address and the name, what gives us a registration in our WordPress page. The new member is built then, or in our case one earlier. We can create on every answer he gives us, we can add a given tag. We can say this one has completed the quiz. We have a question that asks the gender. We know, is it a woman or a man? We know which industry he's in. We have maybe a question that targets the volume of trade he makes in a month. That helps us to find out, will he be able to for our service or not, or is he still in the beginning, more a startup? We can find out, is he a decision maker or more an influencer in this company? So what I like to say with that is, it gives us so much in terms of who we are dealing with, that helps us to send him, as an example, a mail that is much more appropriate for him, and it is maybe not for another person. So we make individual automation that send the given person exactly what they are looking for, so that they don't get bored with our emails. Everyone that works in sales knows about the general rule that a prospect needs to hear from you 5, 6 or even much more times, that he starts believing in you, that he knows enough about you that he can do a next step. It is about building trust, and that's exactly what prospect nurturing is all about. So in the past, you would have done, in a normal sales team, you do follow-up calls, you send a manual email. When we do sales automation for our customers, we try to get a warmed-up customer with an automated sequence. So it will allow you to nurture or work on much more prospect clients, and the idea is that the ones that are really fitting you, the ones that are really looking for your service, are start booking calls with you, they start finding you, they look for you, and you don't have to disturb them with cold calls. Nobody. Maybe a few words about me. My name is Andreas Koller. I was born in Switzerland. Since a number of years, I'm living in Kenya, or I'm jumping up and for. I'm a tech consultant and serial entrepreneur since 1992, and I have watched all the steps of the internet since then. Today, I'm happy to share with people my knowledge. I love to build sales automation for companies that like to make a change for their company. Let's zoom out shortly, and I like to show you what the bigger path is. Today we talked about prospect nurturing. Generally, what we do is we build sales automation machines for customers. We build it for them, we build it with them together. Most likely it is a together, as the building of the content is a job that a company has to do on its own. What I give is the roadmap to go there. Today we are looking at this single step. Now you see the complete process we have structured in a 9-step process that goes up until you have a running machine that creates you quality prospects, and you can stop doing cold calls at all. I like you to look at this map a bit closer. We usually do in the first step, we formulate together a mission. I do this in some consulting sessions that has an outcome where I build a project plan. I give you a budget for your project, and you can then make a decision based on that, and we go through the process all together. It's now your choice to move on the way you already know, or you can get in touch with us and we find out together what we can do for you. We can build this project plan for you, and in 90 days you could have actually a sales automation machine running, and I would be happy to help you. I hope you liked my video. I'm sure you find a link that brings you to our website, or you find the link where you can book the fast track call. I would be happy when you share this video, or when you would do a step and get in touch to me. I'm looking forward to hear from you. Thank you.